let me just tell you, we are so excited about having so many of our partners who are here, who really have a vested interest in our students and seeing our students succeed. You know, our Pulaski Automotive program has been around for a number of years, and it's been at the latest, it's always been at the cutting edge of technology, and today is no different. Our program has had many firsts within our district and within our state. In 1997, our school was the first Wisconsin school to be a part of the prestigious automotive apprenticeship program. We were the first school to receive this grant from the Department of Transportation for this hybrid and alternative fuel vehicle program that we offer our students today. Among many firsts, that is the purpose for us being here today.
First of all, this is an absolutely fantastic facility. Not only in the quality of what you see around you and the size, but the environment that's created for education and getting these kids excited about science and technology, engineering and math, and graduating. So this is just really terrific. And you know, to the students, I'm just going to tell you, this kind of facility does not exist in many places. So you should be very proud. And Dr. Thornton, to the administrators, what you have done to create this excellent learning environment is really, really wonderful.
Thank you so much.
And to you, my friend, Chancellor Lovell, what you see around here is our pipeline. And these are the folks that we want to get going to UWM when you graduate. So this is terrific. We're really glad to be here. So now that I don't have my hand free. So, as an engineer, this is about the most fun that we can have. And I also brought my engineers and scientists with me because it's an opportunity for us to share the things that make us get up in the morning, we're really passionate about, and share it with the students who want to also learn about how things work and why they work, and hopefully instill a passion and excitement for them to go on and pursue careers in science, technology, and engineering. Because one day, Mike, as you said, every student that comes into our labs, we'd like to see you become Johnson Controls employees. These electric vehicles that are behind you that Johnson Controls is donating, we see this as an investment in our community here, an investment in these students, an investment in helping us develop the talent pipeline that's so needed to compete globally. Unfortunately, if you look at the United States, we are just falling behind in terms of our ability to keep up with the technology and graduating students in the STEM disciplines. These kinds of opportunities are the opportunities that allow us to not only catch up, but set the bar and become a destination where people are going to want to come to school and create an environment where we are training these students for the jobs of the future and bringing them here. So this is really, really important. So it's way beyond just vehicles. What you may not know is Johnson Controls is a 126-year-old company, and we're a multi-industrial company. We're in building efficiency, automotive, and power solutions, which is where I'm housed, and we're the world's largest battery manufacturer in the world. But if you think about the DNA of Johnson Controls, we're about energy efficiency in all of our businesses. And those vehicles that we donated are representative of continuing to develop energy efficiency solutions as we think about propelling ourselves in the vehicles in which we drive. Johnson Controls also is headquartered here in Milwaukee, so it's really important that we're invested in the community and we're invested in helping the students get the education and the job opportunities.
It's programs like these that are going to expand the dreams and attract students like the ones I've met today who are just remarkable, that I would actually be thrilled if you matriculated to UWM. And I'm sure Marianne would be thrilled if you graduated from Kimball for her, because we need you. Our country needs you. We all need you. And I think that programs like this, when I think about what is happening here, the fact that we have cutting-edge technology being developed right here in high schools, is something that will set Milwaukee and this region apart from other parts of the country. And we're working very, very hard with Johnson Controls right now as an institution to make Milwaukee the energy storage and battery center, not only for the U.S., but the entire world. And when I look at what we need to do, we need to attract students from MPS to be that workforce that's going to drive this forward.
And you're learning how to speak Greek in terms of technology, in terms of moving this community forward. And I'll tell you why it's important. It's important to me for two reasons. One, this is in the sweet spot of what we're trying to do with the city. And what I mean by that is that we have an Office of Sustainability, and we have a sustainability director. We've got other people who work on the green team, and we have already installed charging locations in the city of Milwaukee. There's one on Brady Street, there's one in Central City, there's one at Discovery World, there's one down in Alderman Wachowski's district at the airport, because we want this city to be ready for more electric vehicles. So we're trying, and those came from the federal stimulus dollars, just so everybody knows where those dollars came from. We're trying to make the city more prepared. Just in the last month, we've dedicated a new compressed natural gas filling station on Lincoln Avenue here on the south side, so that we can sell compressed natural gas to the public. And in our own fleet, we have authorized the purchase of electric vehicles. We've got natural gas vehicles, because part of the infrastructure of a city, our transportation vehicles, we want to make sure that we are diversified as well. So to Johnson Controls, thank you for your leadership and everything that you've done. And to let you know that we're trying to keep up with these changes as quickly as they're coming. The second reason that this is so important to me is the biggest frustration that I have when it comes to workforce is what I call the ships passing in the night phenomenon, where I'll talk to students or young people, and sometimes people in middle-aged people, who go through training programs, and they come out and they're not prepared. And then they put in a lot of work, they're not prepared, and it's frustrating to them. On the other hand, I talk to employers who have people who come through training programs, and they're not prepared either. And so the more we can have hands-on, real-world experience, like the experience you're getting here, right here in Pulaski, the better off you are, the better off future employers are, the better off this city is. So to me, this is a win on every single front. And I am just delighted that you have the opportunity to learn this. And again, you're fresh, you're inquisitive, you're going to learn a lot, and this is going to benefit you for the rest of your lives.
You know, it's wonderful when it all comes together. And what the day proves is it's a collective effort, it's the collective impact of us as a city. You have your mayor sitting here. We have a pipeline from MATC. I know the provost, she's here, she was here. And the MATC team is here. There you go. And then you have UWM sitting here. And then you have the Automotive Foundations in here. Gary, thank you for your work. And then you have an entire science STEM team over at MATC, over at Johnson Control here. All of us working together to hopefully make lives better for children. This is what I know. Our children can do this work, and they will do this work, and they will make you proud. Johnson Control, you made a big investment. But I will tell you, the return will be threefold as these young people take their place. Greg is saying this is the kind of program we talk about all the time. This is the kind of work that we need to make life and education authentic to our children. Just imagine, coming together, we took some of our stimulus dollars, Mayor, and we actually retrofitted the lab. And then with the grant that Dr. Williams spoke of, we trained our teachers, and I want to salute teachers, because let me tell you, we can't do it without you. I have the pleasure of bringing up our number one pit team. Come on up, guys. Come on up. Put you all in the seat. Come on, here.